Welcome back to another episode of the Azure Enablement Show. Today, we are going to have a look how you can deploy your Azure Landing Zones using Bicep. And make sure to check out the links in the description below, as well as subscribe to the show so you don't miss any episodes. Welcome back. My name is Thomas, and I'm here with Jack and Jan from the Azure Landing Zone Bicep team to talk about the Azure Landing Zone Bicep tooling and why it was created and why it's there and how you actually can get started to deploy your landing zones using Bicep. So Azure Landing Zones, for those who are new, are obviously a great way for organizations to build their platform in Azure to make sure that everything is done using best practices. Now, in this episode, again, we're going to talk about how you can do that using Bicep. And I'm, again, happy to have Jack and Jan here from the team. So before we dive into this, and you're obviously going to show us also a little bit about this in this episode and a couple of others, can you tell me a little bit about what the difference is between Azure Landing Zones and enterprise scale, for example?
Yeah, that's a great question, Thomas. And actually, there is nothing different between them, right? It's a simple thing where we are migrating it through our sort of marketing journey where it was called Enterprise Scale originally, and we're migrating that to become the Azure Landing Zone. So if you see Enterprise Scale or you see Azure Landing Zone, know they are the same thing.
Oh, that's fantastic. Good. Thank you very much for clarifying this, because we used obviously both terms a lot. So we're going to talk about Bicep today, but obviously there are different options how you can deploy your landing zones. So what are the different implementation options organizations have?
Yeah, absolutely. So we started with the initial portal accelerator, so where you can go through sort of a GUI-based experience in the Azure portal and fill out some radio buttons and some text fields, and you can deploy it that way. We are obviously going to talk about Bicep today, so I'll leave that for a little bit later. But we also have the Azure Landing Zones Terraform module as well. So if you're a Terraform-based customer, you can choose to deploy the Azure Landing Zones architecture via our Terraform module as well.
Perfect. Great to have like different options here. So again, we're talking about Azure Landing Zone Bicep today. Can you tell me a little bit why this was built?
Yeah, mainly based off customer feedback, right? So on the portal-based accelerator, we had a couple of issues raised saying, hey, it'd be great if we could have this in Bicep when Bicep was first announced. And hence, we were like, yeah, that's a great idea. You know, that's the way that, you know, Azure native infrastructure as code tooling is progressing. Let's, you know, take it on board and start developing this in Bicep so that customers can start with our recommended infrastructure as code tooling in Azure from day one.
Awesome. So Jan, I have a question for you here as well. So for customers who now want to start and working with the Azure Landing Zone Bicep tooling, where do they go?
So that's an excellent question. Let me just share my screen. So as you can see, Azure Landing Zone for Bicep lives in GitHub, in this GitHub repo that we created with a README file in root of the repo. And the base of the modules are in the infra as code Bicep folder, where we have Caramel, which are some modules that we leveraged from another project, and orchestration, which I'll get back to in a later session. And then we have the modules folder, where we have the different modules that we're using for deploying landing zones with Bicep. So if we go into look at the management groups folder, for instance, you'll see the module for actually creating management groups. So there's the Bicep folder and the root of the folder. And then we have parameters, where we have two different flavors of parameter files. So one is the parameters all folder, which is basically containing all the parameters which are required for that particular module. And then we have minimum, which are the minimum required parameters for the module, and the rest will then be specified by default. And also we have the README here for the specific module, containing a bit of information about what is it that we're deploying, and also a bit of information about parameters, and especially about output and so on, and also about how we actually deploy the module, what are the commands that we need to run. And this is done for both Azure CLI and for PowerShell, and for Azure Global and for Azure China.
Okay, so you mentioned that there are like these different modules, right? Can you explain me, like, how would now identify which different modules I actually need to deploy? And is there a specific order for me to keep in mind how to deploy these?
That's a very good question. The modules were originally designed to be able to be deployed individually, but I mean, there are dependencies. For instance, we have the management groups as a requirement to deploy policy definitions and role definitions and so on and so forth. So what we did was we created the deployment flow where we have this nice graphic showing that, first of all, you need to deploy the management group module, then the policy definition, then role definitions, and then so on and so forth with the specific order that you want to do it in. Also, we actually have the order down here in the table where we also obviously have it sorted in order. And we also provide a little description of what the individual modules do, if there are any specific prerequisites, such as, you know, owner role permissions or something like that. And then we have a link to the README file that I showed just before with the specific deployment instructions.
Okay, perfect. So now I understand. Okay, so I know now where I need to go to actually get all these modules, and I understand, okay, how do I, like, which one to choose and the order and where I find that information. So now if I actually want to deploy this, how do I start?
Excellent question. So the first thing I'd need to do would be to actually clone the repo to a client somewhere, or I won't be able to do anything. So I'll just go here and get the clone URL. And then I've started a cloud shell here, and I'll just clone the repo. There we go. And now I want to show you something, because the first thing was, as we just discussed, we want to deploy the management groups first. And as you can see in this particular tenant, we don't actually have any management groups yet, or we have only the tenant root group. So what I'm going to be doing is I'll be deploying that particular, the management groups now to this tenant. So I'll go here and I'll go back to the deployment flow. I'll go to management groups, scroll down to the command line. And as you noticed, I opened a partial cloud shell, so I'll just use that one. Copy that and go here and copy that in. Now, since we are doing the Azure Enablement Show, what I'll be doing is I'll just open Visual Studio's code and I'll go to Azure Landing Zone for Bicep, Infra's code, modules, management groups, parameters, open the parameters all file and change this to AES and change the display name to Azure Enablement Show.
Okay, so if I would be a company or an organization, I would put in my personal like names and stuff in for that.
Indeed, that is very much the case. Yes, absolutely. There we go. I saved it. And now I can just buy it. And now it's running, and it will take a couple of minutes to complete.
So that took about 5 minutes. So if we go to up here, we can see that the deployment succeeded and it's deployed everything. So let's go and see what that looks like. So you'll notice that this was before, and I'll just do a refresh. And now we have a nice Azure Enablement Show management hierarchy here. And if we drill deeper into that, we can see that we have, so the prefix here goes into all the names. And then we have a Azure Landing Zones, we have platform, we have sandbox. And if we drill further into it, we have core and online, and we have platform connectivity, identity and management and sandbox.
Okay. That is pretty cool. So with these Bicep modules and templates, we can really deploy the whole Azure Landing Zone infrastructure. We just saw right now the management groups, right? But there's obviously more, like setting up networking and other stuff as well. So like pretty cool. And again, we will talk more about, I think, in the next episodes about this. But so check if now people want to get started with this and they want to see if they want to, for example, have a look at this repo to work with that. Where do they go?
Yeah, absolutely. So they can head to the short link of aka.ms/alz/bicep, and that will take you to the root of the repository, and you can find the deployment flow page from there and get cracking.
Awesome. And we have more episodes planned. So what do we expect? What can we expect from the next episodes?
Yeah, no, absolutely. So we're going to take you through pretty much deploying the entire ALZ Bicep repository. So as you said, right, deploying the networking policies, some of the logging modules, the security, everything you see in the big picture, you should be see deployed by the end of all of these episodes.
Awesome. That's fantastic. So thank you very much, Jan and Jack. It was great to have you on this episode today. And thank you for everyone watching. And make sure you check out aka.ms/adopt.